Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and in this video we are going to add an earth. We are going to add materials and textures to our SCN nodes. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay. Let's open up our Xcode project, and I have created a little bit of comments here what we are going to talk about. First of all, we are going to download our materials from this site, solarsystemscope.com, and we will go to the textures there where we can download them. But what for? Because as you saw, we only added only one texture. Well, that is only the diffuse texture. That means that that is what you can see. Now, there are a lot of other material properties that you can add to your SCN nodes, and that is the specular, emission, and normal, to just name a few, and the most important ones as well. So, specular is when the amount of light that is reflected in a mirror-like manner. Well, that means is that if you set it to white, then all of the light will be reflected. If you set it to black, then no light will be reflected. You will see later on when we download our specular resource. Now, the emission. The emission property specifies the amount of light the material emits. This emission does not light up other surfaces in the scene. That is just a little thought there. But what does this really mean is that when you put this material on a surface, on the surface of our SCN node, then it emits a certain light. And that will be awesome when we put the clouds onto our Earth. So, and the last one is normal. The normal property specifies the surface orientation. Now, that is kind of a coding language, but what this actually does is that you can see the ups and downs, the valleys, the mountains in your globe. And you can also specify, let's say we are talking about a football, and we want to carve out those little boxes. That is how you can indent them inside that, okay? And you will see this action inside our Earth SCN node. First, so let us just go with Command and tap on this link so we can be taken to our solarsystemscope.com and select the textures. And let's just scroll down till you see the Earth. And first of all, let us just download our diffuse. So select our high resolution, ultra resolution could be also downloaded, but it may take a little while to load into the scene. I will just use the high resolution. And I will just make this as big as I can and save image as. Okay, and I will save it into my resources. Let's save that. Okay, and now back to Xcode. I'm going to go to assets and create a new image set. And I will name this image set. Okay, and now let's go to our resources and simply just drag and drop this material, this JPEG file into our assets folder. Okay, for now, here we have our diffuse, and let us just build up our SCN node next. So go to Game View Controller, and we are going to add this SCN node when we press our plus button. So let's find handle plus button, and I will just comment this add node out with command and a slash, and now let's just type in. Okay, and I will create this function just down below here. Okay, now let's get started. First of all, let us create an earth node, not a capital H, earth node, and this will be a simple SCN node, and let's initialize it, and now let us just give it a geometry of a sphere. So, and we will use this radius, and it will be, let's say, 20 centimeters of a radius. Okay, and finally, let us just put it somewhere. So, Earth node dot position, and this will be SCN vector free, and I want to put it, let's say, 0.5 meters behind the origin. So 0, 0, and minus 0.5. Okay, and now let us just add it to the scene. So, and that is how you can add. But now you only have a white sphere, and if we want to test it out, you have only a white sphere in your scene. To add this diffuse, let us just go back to our geometry and Earth node geometry. And now let us select our first material and type in diffuse and contents. And now let us just add our simple Earth diffuse UI image. Okay, and that should take care of that. Let us just test this out. Let's select our phone here and let's build and run. Okay, now let's just wait for it a little minute, and let us just add our globe by pressing on the plus button. Here we go. As you can see, we have a pretty nice globe here. Okay, and the image just wrapped around that sphere. Good stuff. Now, let's just stop this and let's talk about the second material property, and that is specular. Well, the specular property specifies the amount of light to reflect in a mirror-like mode. So for that, let us just download a specular resource, and I will just go back to our site here and I will just download this specular. And as you can see now, let me just go to downloads. We have a TIFF file here, so I will just rename this to PNG and select use PNG. And of course, you might want to delete this one. I have downloaded this file multiple times and it is in my downloads folder, so this is how our computer just named it. Okay, next up is to add this to Xcode's assets folder. So I will just create here a specular new image set named Specular Earth. And now I just simply drag and drop this. I am naming this because if you just simply drag and drop it into the assets folder, then it will be named 2K underscore Earth underscore specular underscore map. And that is a huge take in, especially if you come back to your code after several months. So Earth specular is to name our material. And now I will just add this Earth node geometry first material, and now I will just type in specular and contents and find Earth specular. Good stuff. And as you can see, it is, let me just open this, black and white. Well, the white will be reflecting light, and the black will not reflect light at all. So the oceans will reflect light and the ground will not reflect any light at all. And that is a way to make this globe quite amazing to look at. So I'll just show you once again. Okay, here it is. Let's add our globe here. And as you can see, here we have a reddish light. And once I go to the land, the reddish light does not seem to be there at all. And here it is, specular material. Okay, next up is emission. Now the emission property specifies the amount of light the material emits, and we will add a clause material. So let us just download this Earth clouds. Let's make it as big as possible and let's save image. This is great. And now I will just simply create, as usual, a new image set. And I will name this. And let me just take a look at, we are going to use emission. So let's rename it this now, Earth emission. And simply just drag and drop our clouds JPEG file. Okay. And now, finally, let's add our emission to our geometry. So, let's build and run again and see this in action, and it should look quite fantastic. Let's wait for the region. Here it is. And here we have our clouds. You can see much more dynamic, much more interesting glow. Okay, next up is to add our normal that will basically add our mountains and valleys. Okay, as usual, let's go to our site, let's move back, and here we have our Earth normal map. Let's download it. And as you can see, it's again a TIFF file, so I will just rename this to a PNG file. PNG. Okay, let's use PNG. And next up, let us just create a new image set here that will be called. And just drag and drop it there. And now for the coding part. Pretty straightforward if you have been following along. Earthnode.geometry. First material dot and now normal dot contents equals to Earth normal. Good stuff. Now let us just see how all of this looks like on our iPhone 10. Okay, there it is. Let's add our globe and let me just go there. And If you take a look at it in more detail, then you will see those little things. There it is. Well, mountains are quite small compared to the whole sphere of the globe. But there you have it. You have added a normal map. And now let us just move this globe because our Earth is turning around. So let us just type in here, after we added our Earth, we are going to create an action. So let's type in rotate. And this will be an SCN action. And this, let's just type in rotate by, and we want to rotate it by the Y axis. So 0 for the X, and for the Y axis, we want to add 360 degrees. So we want to type in here degrees to radians, and Z is 0, and duration, let's say 15 seconds is what I have tested to be fairly a good rotation. And let's just fix this. Let's change this to CG float. Okay, now what we want to do is that this moves, rotates the Earth around by a full 360 degrees in 15 seconds. What we want to do is make this movement repeat forever. So let's just create another action here. And this will be again as SCN action. And let's just repeat forever the rotate action. Okay, and finally we want to apply this action to our Earth node. So Earth node. Now let's just build and run again, and let's see how all of this looks like. Our globe here, there it is. And pretty nice, pretty good stuff. Now it is rotating, and if I would have If I just wait more than 50 minutes, then the whole globe will just turn around again and again. But what if I tap on the plus button again? Well, a new globe is added once again. So we want to fix this. We want to add only one Earth. So for that, we want to enumerate through all of the children named Earth. And for that, I will just create the name of our Earth node to be. Okay, and when we tap on the plus button, then we want to check if there is an Earth node named Earth at all in the scene. So let us just scroll back, and here, before add Earth, we want to check. So first of all, let's type in arview.scene.enumerate. scene.rootNode.enumerateChildNodes, and here we type in a node, so we may get the node, and the unsafe pointer is unnecessary for now. So if the node name equals to Earth, then we don't want to add anything else. So we are going to introduce here a Boolean value, so a variable, does Earth node exist in scene, because we want to make our variables as explicit as possible. So this is false for now, and if we found an Earth, then does Earth node exist in scene is set to true. Okay, and now finally, we want to add our Earth only if does Earth not exist in scene is false. So if not does Earth not exist in scene, then we will add our Earth. Otherwise, we do nothing. Okay, pretty basic stuff, but now we should get rid of that error. Okay, let's unlock this. Now we should get rid of that nasty plus button. Okay, as you can see, I am pressing the plus button, but no extra Earth are added to the scene. Good stuff. Okay, now that is it for this lesson. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you are on this channel for the first time and you want to see more videos of me explaining iOS stuff the cool way. And of course, go ahead and check out our site, rebeloper.com. That is rebeloper.com. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.